Welcome back, audiophiles. Ossie here. Today we are going to be conducting an in-depth comparison of various calibration microphones, seeking to find out the effective difference between a budget microphone and a top-tier one. We will evaluate the accuracy of the included batch calibration files that come with most of these microphones and explore the potential for improving the precision of a cheap microphone by creating more accurate calibration files. Our reference microphone hails from Earthworks, a brand favored by top professionals and studios, and a specific model, M23R, is their reference-grade precision condenser microphone, offering exceptionally accurate and flat response, good polar pattern, low distortion, very low noise, and high output for its size. It will be amplified with a reference Motu Ultralight MK5 audio interface with distortion and noise levels even below the limits of M23R. The first contender is the cheapest calibration microphone money can buy, Behringer ECM8000, available for $30 in the US for the uncalibrated version. The second contender is Mini DSP's highly regarded plug-and-play USB microphone, the U-Mic 2, positioned between the top and bottom contenders in terms of price. And we will also assess how Odyssey's standard calibration microphone, ACM1HP, stacks up against this competition. It's important to note that none of these companies are sponsoring this video or have provided me with any devices. I personally acquired all of them, investing quite a bit more than the total income of this channel since its launch over a year ago. Here is the comparison of the technical specifications of these microphones. Earthworks, Behringer, and Odyssey Mic are all analog devices. Odyssey can be directly plugged into your PC's sound card microphone input, while M23R and ECM8000 require an audio interface with phantom power to work. U-Mic 2 is a plug-and-play USB mic and doesn't require any additional gear. Earthworks and U-Mic 2 comes with their individual calibration files. Behringer doesn't come with one. The same model with a calibration file is sold at nearly twice the price. And Odyssey mics have a hidden batch calibration file applied to them in the receivers. I had made a video on how to extract that in the past, and you can watch it by clicking this link at the top right corner now, but what we will create at the end of this video will be a lot more accurate than that batch calibration file, at least for my unit, and I'll share a download link for all calibration files we will create in this video in the description section below. These are the best prices I could find online in US and Europe for these devices. The most expensive microphone is 20 times as expensive as the cheapest one. Unfortunately, we have some import tax. Interestingly, U-Mic is the same price in Europe and US in dollars and euros, but Earthworks comes with an import duty tax. Dynamic range of M23R is double that of Behringer. U-Mic 2 is a close contender at 125 dB. However, based on the sensitivity data embedded in my individual calibration file for U-Mic 2, the actual dynamic range of my unit, at least, is around 112 dB, according to Rumi QUizard. The USB microphone's calibration files need to have a sensitivity value stated in their calibration file for REW to adjust relative gain. These are the other contenders' sensitivity values calculated by REW from their dynamic range. Given the fact that human pain threshold is 130 dB, I guess this is still more than enough. To ensure consistency, uniformity, and accuracy, I used Rumi QUizard's Pro Upgrade version in this tutorial, which allowed me to measure a speaker response with a single sweep with multiple microphones at multiple locations simultaneously. This eliminated variations in placement, room noise, and distortion from one measurement to the other. Although the Pro Upgrade is primarily designed for precision multiple point SPL measurements using microphone arrays, it could easily be adapted for microphone calibration with a few simple tricks. Here is the setup. All microphones are bundled together firmly with an elastic band and aimed directly at the tweeter of a focal counter floor standing speaker from a distance of around 1 meter. While close proximity to the speaker and tweeter height wasn't essential, it didn't require any extra effort and at least ensured a better signal to noise ratio for the tested measurements. Each microphone is oriented such that their activity lights or brand tags are at the top, minimizing the impact of capsule polar deviations. The distance between the centers of the microphone tips in this triangular configuration is precisely 2 centimeters. This equates to a wavelength just above 17 kHz, so we can reasonably assume that our test accuracy is limited to 17,000 Hz at the upper end of the frequency range. At the lower end, we are able to reach down to 3 Hz thanks to the ultra-wide frequency bandwidth of the Earthworks microphone. Archie closely supervised the setup throughout, ensuring the measurement procedure didn't steal the spotlight from him at any time. Now let's begin the process. Start by opening up Rumi QUizard, as always. Pro Upgrade with multiple input capture license is identical in every way to the free version of REW, except for the added functionalities related to multiple microphone measurements. I didn't have time yet to explore it in full, but there are a lot of interesting features, especially on the RTA measurements front, and so far it seems well worth the very reasonable price I paid. Now, the main difference is in the preferences sound card tab. There is a multiple inputs option that you can tick. When it's unticked, it's the same as the standard tray with just one microphone connected. You select that microphone, it will measure the sweep with this microphone. But when you select multiple inputs, go to ASIO control panel. I guess you can also use Java exclusive drivers, but I prefer ASIO. Every single microphone connected and you select here, like activate and reload, will measure this sweep. Here it's a Odyssey microphone connected to the sound card, which I don't want to measure at this stage. This is my player, which will play from the left speaker. And this is irrelevant, a laptop Bluetooth. This is also multi-channel surround amplifier. This is the microphone that is recording this speech at the moment, so I hope it's not taken over by ASIO. And your mic is here, you can select it. And this is the audio interface to which two analog microphones are connected now simultaneously. Okay, and Rev decides one and two, names them as one and two. You could select the first microphone and the last microphone, and Rev will measure every microphone in between this array of microphones, the same sine sweep. But to just show you very quickly what the effect of a precision calibration file will be on a cheap microphone, I will just compare two microphones connected to the same audio interface for this test. So reload and make sure every correct thing is selected with the play sign active, and that's it. No loop back. And now calibration files. Earthworks come with this calibration file, which actually doesn't even need according to its spec. And the Behringer comes with no calibration file, so it's empty. This is irrelevant. Everything else the same here. Comms analysis, equalizer view, standard. Now we go to measure window. And this is also very similar to normal measurement, standard measurement. Actually, you don't even see any sign here that you will do a multiple microphone measurement. Output is the left channel, left speaker, in front of which there are an array of microphones. And start. Just make sure the calibration files are in place one more time. And here we go. This is the difference of the Rev Pro upgrade. You see these gray areas around the average measurement, which is the red line. The gray area is the variation between measurement microphones, and the red line is the average. So between a cheapest microphone and the best microphone out there, this is the difference. You can see from upper mid onwards, quite large deviations, and also from around sub bass, even in the bass area, quite a bit. In fact, apart from the low mids, almost nowhere it's identical to the correct measurement without any calibration file. Okay, and we can extract both microphone measurements from this. But before that, let me not forget, we didn't game match the microphones beforehand, so we will do it here manually. Go to adjust average, not this one, but use this one, and align SPL and update average. I prefer to align at 1 kHz centered, 2.5 octaves each way. And once you do that, actually it's even better. And you can here adjust the weight of each microphone. So assuming they were in different locations in the room and whatnot, but for our purposes, they will be equally weighted. So this is the Earthworks measurement. This is the Behringer measurement, and the red line is their average. So the variations are now in fact even less when they are SPL aligned, but still problems are in the same area. And you can see that here there is like a 7 dB difference at 11.5 kHz and here at 35 Hz there is 1.7 dB. And interestingly, even at here, 300 Hz, there is 1.8 dB. And the lower down, the higher up the frequency band, the worse the difference gets. To extract each microphone measurement from this, you just untick number 2. So now this is only Earthworks. Close it, go to All SPL, Measurement Actions, and Response Copy. And this one is your M23R Earthworks reference measurement with the calibration file. Go back to it again, SPL and phase, and adjust average. Now this time tick 2 and untick 1. Close, All SPL, response copy, and this is your ECM 8000 response. When you fit them to data, you can see separately ECM not the average, but ECM versus, well, the color didn't really match. Yeah, ECM versus the actual measurement, actual speaker response. If you apply some smoothing, you can even have a better understanding of the differences. And this is SPL aligned, as you see. There is no movement when you align the SPL. So this is the difference between a very cheap and the very best microphone. Now what we can do about it? Back to no smoothing. Go to trace arithmetic. Logically, you should divide the reference by the ECM response and magnitude division without any phase, and regularization is zero. But because of the way the calibration files are processed in REW, you have to do the reverse of that. So divide ECM 8000's response with the reference response and generate. And we will see around 0 dB now. There's a calibration file already produced for us. This is the calibration file for ECM 8000. And let's call this ECM 8000 0 degree cal file precision. We couldn't. Precision cal. And what you do now is export as text. You can use range of measurements, but above Nyquist there will be division problems. So custom range 5 to 22,000, something beyond audible range. Resolution of measurement, smoothing of measurement, and do not include any comments and headers. Before we do that, by the way, in the Pro upgrade, for example, if you wanted to export this one, the combined measurement, here you had the option of include individual input responses and multi-input capture export. When you tick this, you get all the microphones that measured together and their average. You can export them all at once and then do any kind of manipulation in Excel or what have you, if you need. Anyway, back to our calibration file export. Export this as text, and with these settings, this is gonna be our ECM 8000 precision calibration 0 degree file. Now let's do the same measurement, but this time upload this calibration file to our ECM. Okay, here precision calibration 0 degrees, close and start measuring. This is our new measurement. Let's do the SPL alignment first. Okay, and look at this. Now from this, sorry, this is still only one measurement. Yeah, this was how it was SPL aligned, and from this we came to this. You can see that the variations, the gray areas, have shrunk massively, and at this point the ECM is almost as accurate as the earthwork. I would say down to 40 hertz and up to 2k hertz, but at least in this region, which is the most important part, you can equalize and filter when calibrating your speakers. You can get as accurate measurements as you would do with the best calibration microphone out there. I can extract them separately, but this is what it is. Now let's measure all the microphones together, or at least try. This is Odyssey here, and let's add U-Mic to the equation and reload and see. Yeah, this one is loaded, this one is loaded, looks like it's there. Now it starts from HD audio mic input 1. This is Odyssey. It is a mono microphone, but the sound card doesn't understand it. I hope it doesn't create confusion. So this is the first microphone and this is the last microphone. As you see, we have now 6 microphone measurements and no look back. And as for the calibration files, there should be more than that. No, it's not really seeing the USB mic. Let's start from U-Mic 1. Yeah, now it's better. See, with USB in the equation, there is always a little bit of problem because it's a totally different interface, totally different sensitivity measurement and etc. So separate file for Odyssey, although I have created a measurement file for Odyssey, but this one will be more precise. And for U-Mic, let's put the standard factory individual calibration file that I have been given. Keep U-Mic 2 without calibration file so we can create one. This one is Earthworks, the reference, and this one is now our precision. Should I upload this or not? No, better leave it without calibration as it was. Check levels. Now let's measure. Okay, and this is now with all four microphones connected together. Let's adjust the SPL. And as you see, the variations are now larger than with two microphones. There is our Odyssey here. There is the uncalibrated Behringer. There is U-Mic uncalibrated and U-Mic calibrated. Everything is in here. You can extract them one by one and you can create precision calibration file for all of them. For the sake of the length of this video, I won't go through that, but I will leave a link in the description area for all the precision calibration files I created for all these microphones. You can make use of them. And for anyone who's wondering the performance of U-Mic 2 microphone compared to the M23R, this is uncalibrated U-Mic 2 versus perfectly calibrated Earthworks. Yellow line is Earthworks response for the same measurement. And this is with no calibration file. And here is the precision calibration file generated from this for the U-Mic 2 for my particular unit. And this is what came as individual calibration file from factory. So looks like they are doing a good job. They're just smoothing it down. And there is up to 1 dB difference, around maximum difference in the important frequency band. Anything above 17,000 is not even valid in this measurement anyway. So this is what it is. And for much of their usage, cheap calibration microphones are more than adequate. We have shown in this video that they can be calibrated to precision levels which can compete with the very best microphones out there. You can borrow a precisely calibrated microphone from a friend and calibrate your own microphone with it, or you can send your microphone to calibration centers. There are companies who specialize in that, both in Europe and in the US. But remember, they will have clear limitations like dynamic range, noise floor, consistency from unit to unit, stability over time, and environmental conditions like temperature and humidity. And an expensive microphone has the advantage that they can consistently measure similarly at different temperatures and different humidities and whatnot, and over time also. And even Earthworks, by the way, in the manual advises to recalibrate the microphone every 5 years. Remember to subscribe if you still haven't, because the next video will be about how to correctly set a loopback for sound card calibration and a loopback for timing reference. Yes, they are different things. And the advantages of analog loopback setups compared to USB setups on accurate phase extraction. Ideally, every microphone should come with a phase calibration file as well. And they don't do that. Even Earthworks don't supply something like that. I asked them. But you can generate the minimum phase version of the calibration file, which will fix things a little bit on the phase front. But the major difference with an analog microphone and a USB microphone in the phase extraction is massive. So I want to show you that. We will also test how close we can get to the very best audio interfaces with the cheapest of the audio interfaces, the Behringer Euphoria UM2, $39 as we speak. So that's it for today, folks. I hope you enjoyed. Bye bye.